She's the highest selling female solo artist of all time, and her rags to riches tale is legendary. It is Céline Dion.
Want to hear a fairy tale? Once upon a time, there was a sweet little princess born to a poor French-Canadian family, the youngest of 14 children. This little girl, let's call her Céline, loved to sing. By age 5, she was standing on tables in her family's humble restaurant, belting out tunes for the customers. She was not beautiful. In fact, kids poked fun at her pointy teeth and called her the vampire. But by age 12, this little princess had made a tape and sent it to a knight in shining armor, a Canadian record producer. Let's call him René. He was enchanted by Céline and mortgaged his castle to finance her first record. She was an instant hit and toured Europe, but still something was missing. She was too young, too green, spoke no English, and there was the issue of those teeth. She dropped out for a year and fixed everything, and the little Canadian goose emerged a beautiful, shining swan. The Princess of Pop became arguably the most successful recording artist of the decade. And her name, Céline Dion, became synonymous with dramatic movie theme songs. The theme from Titanic has sold nearly 60 million copies.
Thank you so very much. Have a wonderful
And won Céline another Grammy for Record of the Year.
When it comes to romance films, Céline's voice is usually first choice. But for the theme to the Oscar-winning Titanic, Céline's haunting My Heart Will Go On barely made the cut.
I'm not the kind of filmmaker that would have actively pursued a song to put into the end credits just to sort of sell the film, help market the film. I would never have done that. I like the lyrics, I like the music, I like the resonance of the theme, and I teared up a little bit, you know?
When you see her singing, it's part of the passion of it. It ends up being a distillation of everything an audience feels.
Well, it's clear that Céline and Hollywood go hand in hand.
September 21st, celebrities joined together to raise money for the victims of 9/11. And it was the first time in a year and a half that Céline had sang publicly and the first time she'd have to leave her baby. Céline's rendition of God Bless America, did y'all see that? Moved the world. Take a sneak peek here. One of the most moving moments any of us had ever experienced. Céline will be taking the stage in a brand new 4,000-seat theater that is going to resemble Rome's Colosseum. Are they building it?
Or they're building Colosseum right now.
They're building it, yes. Just for you.
Yep.
So this way she can still perform and
get
be...
Get a lot of toys.
Yes, and be home with her son. Well, that is the deal of a lifetime. That's fantastic.
She was a talented young woman with a voice and determination unparalleled in pop music. Well, 12 years later, she has become the world's top-selling female vocalist.
But now, in a candid interview, the best-selling female artist in music history describes how a new day has come.
Back along the strip, it's the dawn of a new day as the number one-selling female vocalist in the world takes center stage in a specially designed $95 million Coliseum Theater at Caesar's Palace.
Performer at Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas. Tonight she's performing a song from her CD Miracle. Please welcome Celine Dion.
It's over 175 million albums sold. 175 million albums. Wow. Our first guest is the biggest selling female artist in the world. Please welcome five-time Grammy Award winner Celine Dion.
She is the biggest selling female singer of all time. Celine Dion is here.
Celine Dion, the biggest selling female singer ever, talks next on Larry King Live.
Forever this way.
Thank you. You've changed my life and you've changed a lot of people's lives. Bon anniversaire.
After 26 years in the biz, the biggest selling female artist of all time has touched and inspired millions.
So 12 years ago, I hosted the World Music Awards for Monaco, the very first time that they were on American television. And since then, every major recording artist throughout the world has performed on the show. Now, music, you know, like film, is truly a universal language. And tonight, I am here to honor a woman who has performed twice on the show and has won 7 World Music Awards. This evening, she is being recognized with the Diamond Award for her unique achievement as the world's best-selling female artist of all time. She is a Canadian-born artist whose appearance at the Eurovision Song Contest when she was 19 electrified audiences and began a phenomenal career that has made her one of the world's most celebrated performers. All right, now, but before we present this special award, we are going to experience firsthand the sheer energy and artistry of Celine Dion.
Celine Dion.
Thank you very much, Julian. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to all our viewers in the television audience. I have the distinct honor tonight to present a special award to an incredible lady. For decades, she has continued to amaze the world with her thrilling talent, with literally hundreds of millions of albums in print. Her contribution to music is as potent as her courageous voice. I'm talking about the incomparable Celine Dion. Celine, I know I speak on behalf of everyone when I tell you that your voice, which is a force of nature, does far more than entertain. It soothes our hearts and creates smiles of love on people across the face of the earth. And in a world that can be uncertain and even scary at times, how very lucky we are to have you with us and to have with us this tour de force who is truly a light in our world.
Right, for every dream you made come true, for all
200 million albums. Can you believe that? Can you believe that? 200 million albums. I know, when I saw that, I'm like, that is, are that the right number? She's won 5 Grammy Awards and is the best-selling female artist in history.
Tonight, it is my pleasure to welcome you again to the Music Awards and my honor to present you with the Legend Award for Outstanding Contribution to Music, Celine Dion.